What's up, guys? My name's Brandon, and today I'm going to be showing you some new settings in iOS 15 that you need to change on your iPhone right away. So these are going to be settings that will have an impact on your privacy, your battery life, and just overall ease of use throughout iOS 15. And if you want to see an extensive video specifically on how to save battery life on iOS 15, that video will be linked in the cards and down in the description below, along with my video where I show over 300 new features in iOS 15. All right, so now let's go ahead and get into these settings that you should strongly consider changing immediately. The first one has to do with Safari and your IP address. So if we go down in our settings to Safari and then scroll down until we see hide IP address, you want to tap on that and make sure that is turned on. You do not want this off. You want to hide your IP address. And you can see right there, it says your IP address can be used to determine personal information like your location. And this is going to protect you from that. Now you might also see from trackers and websites. So you want to make sure that's enabled. That's only if you have private relay enabled. So if you don't have private relay enabled, you'll only see from trackers, but nonetheless, you should have this enabled. And now that we talked about private relay, we may as well go ahead and talk about that next. So in iOS 15, in iCloud, there is a new feature called private relay, and you can see that right here. If you tap on that, you may want to consider turning this on. So it is currently in beta at the time of recording this, and that's the only reason I have mine currently disabled, because it is kind of spotty with the connection. But once this is out of beta, I will be having this on pretty much the entire time I'm on my device. So this is going to hide your IP address and your internet activity so that websites cannot build a profile for you based on your web activity. Now, this is not a VPN. It only works in Safari, and it can't hide like the region you're connecting from. So you're not going to get the same benefits that you do from a VPN, but this is still a very, very great feature to have built in to iOS now. And when you enable this, you will see that you have a section right here that shows IP address location. If you tap on that, you can maintain general location or use country and time zone. So this is definitely a feature you want to consider turning on, especially once it comes out of beta. So this feature comes with your iCloud Plus subscription, which is the same price as what you were already paying for before iOS 15. So it's going to be free if you were already paying for storage beforehand. And also included in iCloud Plus is the Hide My Email feature. So this is another really great privacy feature in iOS 15 that's going to allow you to use a unique random address that forwards to your actual email address. So this is going to keep your personal emails private. So this is great if you wanted to maybe sign up to a website's newsletter to get a discount, or if you just thought your information might get sold to a third party, you definitely want to have like an alias email set up. And of course, if you start getting spammed, you can delete that alias email and just create a new one very easily. So if you want to just tap on create a new address, you'll see that it gives me a random email here. It just says compact-05stylish@icloud.com. So basically it just combines random words with numbers, and that's what you get for your alias email address. And now you can also label them. So if you want to label your address, so say you signed up for a specific website and this email is only tied to that one website, you can maybe put it in there. So maybe it's like a Target email or something like that. You could do that, and you could also make a note about it, like saying that you signed up for a discount. So you can label them and leave notes if you want to. And then when you tap on next, you are all set. And now if you go down, you will see the email you just set up. And if you tap on it, you can easily deactivate that email right there or change anything that you want to. And then also if you go down even further, you have the forward to section, which will let you change the email that these aliases forward to. Now, the next thing you might want to change has to do with focus modes and notifying others when you are in a focus mode. So as you guys know, in iOS 15, once you enter a focus mode, this is what will show at the bottom for other people who go to text you. It will let them know that your notifications have been silenced, and you can disable this if you go into your settings and go to focus and then go into that focus and then focus status. You could turn it off for everybody, but you might not want it to be off for every single person. You might only want it to be off for specific people, and you can do that. So if we go back into our messages, once you're on a conversation right here with somebody, tap on their contact and you will see a toggle here called share focus status. So you can disable that for a specific contact, and it will no longer show that message. So that is definitely a setting you should consider changing if you don't want specific people seeing when you're in that focus mode. The next setting you guys should change is inside of accessibility. So if we go into our accessibility right here, you want to go down to audio visual and then to background sounds. And this is something I've talked about it so many times. This is one of my favorite features in iOS 15, and I'm kind of surprised that it is not enabled by default. So what this feature does is it plays some background sounds. So you can see you have different ones right here, like the rain, ocean, and just different ambient noises that will help you concentrate or go to sleep. And you can also stop sounds when locked if you want to. And also if you have the hearing control center toggle right here, if you have to press on that, you have a quick little access to background sounds right here where you could turn it on and off easily and also adjust the volume. So I would definitely, you know, recommend enabling background sounds right here and also adding the hearing toggle to your control center if you think you are going to use this at any given point. The next setting you guys should change in iOS 15 is inside of camera. So if we go into camera right here, you want to go to preserve settings, and then you want to make sure that you change your night mode and also live photo. So this is one that drove me crazy, especially night mode. So this is new in iOS 15. So before on iOS 14, when I would turn night mode off, because sometimes it's really annoying, when I would turn it off, you know, I would take the picture without night mode, and then the next time I went into my camera, night mode turned on and ruined my photo, and I had to go in and turn it off again. And I wished that I was able to preserve the settings, but now in iOS 15, you are able to. So I would definitely recommend enabling the preserve settings toggle right here for night mode, and also maybe for live photo or anything else that you see in here that you want to preserve the settings for. So the next time you go into your camera, one of these is not enabled or disabled. Now, the next thing you guys want to change is the notify when left behind feature. So this is also brand new in iOS 15, and this is going to be very beneficial if you have an AirTag and also if you have multiple Apple devices. So if you go into the Find My application and then go to your device, you will see under notifications, it shows notify when left behind. If you tap on that, you can enable that. And you can see it says receive a notification when you leave that product behind. This can be helpful when taking this item with you. And then down here, you also have notify me except at, where you can add in your home address, because obviously if you leave your house without that product, it's not lost. So you don't want to get a notification for that. So this is going to be very beneficial for traveling and just really any other time that you maybe leave something. If you're very forgetful, you may want to have this enabled, especially if like you have an AirTag connected to your keys or something important. The next setting that you need to change is for those with an Apple Card. And this is going to help prevent fraudulent transactions. So if we go into our wallet application here, where our Apple Card is set up, and if we tap on the little card icon up in the top right to view our card information, you will see that we have a new toggle in here for advanced fraud protection. And you could see it says, to keep your card information safe, your security code will change periodically. So you definitely want to make sure that is enabled to prevent fraudulent transactions. And you will see next to your security code, you will now get a new little icon. So that is a must enable feature if you have an Apple Card. The next setting you guys need to change is inside of the mail section. So if you go to mail and then down to privacy protection, you want to make sure that protect mail activity is enabled. This is an important one, and you can see it says mail privacy protection works by hiding your IP address and loading remote content privately in the background, even when you don't open the message. So essentially this feature not only hides your IP address, but it's also going to prevent senders from tracking if you open their email or not. So now people are not going to be able to see if you opened the email or not. They're not going to be able to see if you forwarded the email or not. So basically this is going to prevent follow-up emails and other spammy tactics used by websites and others who have little hidden pixels in the emails. So strongly suggest turning this on if you use mail on your iPhone. Another major privacy feature here in iOS 15 that you need to configure is built-in two-factor authentication. So if you go to your settings and then down to passwords, and then if you tap on the account, you can see at the bottom under account options, we have setup verification code. And if you tap on that, you will see that you can enter a setup key or scan QR code. So now with iOS 15, you do not need to have a third-party application for two-factor authentication, which is really, really nice to have right here on device. Now, if we go back into our accessibility settings, there's another new feature in here that I want you guys to enable, and that is per app settings. Down here at the bottom of accessibility, if you tap on that, you can have per app settings now. So you can customize apps to only do certain things in that application. So let me show you guys what I mean. So I have it set up for Amazon right here. So if you guys don't know, Amazon does not have a dark mode for the application. I know it's 2021, they still don't have it. So you can basically do that with this per app settings. You could have smart invert turned on for Amazon so that now when you go into the Amazon application, it's in a dark mode. So of course it's not a full dark mode, not a real one, but that's just an example of how you could use this. You could also do it for bold text, larger text, and all these different things right here, again, on a per app basis, which is key. And you could also do something similar with the text size control center toggle. So like for instance, if we go into Twitter right here and then go down to the text toggle right here and haptic press on that, you could change the text size for this application only instead of all throughout iOS, which is also kind of an extension of this per app settings feature here in iOS 15, which I'm a big fan of. And I definitely think you guys should consider adding in whatever application you want and configuring it to your liking here. The next thing you guys need to change is inside of the weather application. So if you go into weather and if you tap on these three dots in the bottom right and then tap on the three dots in the top right here, and then go to notifications, I would recommend turning on this right here under current location, my location, turn that on for weather notifications. So this will notify you when it's about to start and stop raining or snowing at your current location. So I'm in Florida, it rains all the time. This is very accurate with notifying me when it's about to rain and when it's about to stop raining. The next thing you guys need to change is inside of the iCloud section, and then inside of iCloud, and then iCloud backup, we have backup over cellular. So this is available on the iPhone 12 and newer because it uses 5G. But what this does is it backs up your iCloud data over 5G instead of Wi-Fi. So I would strongly consider turning that off because that's going to eat through your data and also your battery life. So I would definitely only do iCloud backups when you are connected to Wi-Fi. And Apple even warns you themselves. They say this may cause you to exceed your cellular data plan. So take Apple's and take my advice. The next thing you guys might want to do is go into your settings and go to notifications and then go to scheduled summary and add in the applications that you want to add to your scheduled summary. So this is what it looks like right here on your notification center. It shows your evening summary. This comes in at one specific time per day, and it will show you notifications from applications that you deem as not important enough to send you a push notification, like an important notification. So you can set this up right here. You can have multiple summaries throughout the day. So for me, I only have these three applications because I don't have, you know, a lot of unimportant notifications that I even have enabled. So I have these as just coming in at 6:06 p.m. because I don't want them to come in right when I get them because they're not important enough. So I would schedule this up. You know, a lot of people just say just disable notifications if you don't want them. But to me, there's some notifications that I just want to have on, but I just don't need to know about them right away. So that is what the scheduled summary is for. Now, the next thing you guys should consider changing is inside of Safari, the address bar is going to be something that some people just simply do not like being at the bottom. But thankfully, you can change that. So if you tap on the two A's here in the address bar, you have up top right here, it shows show top address bar. And that will revert the address bar back to being up top like you've been used to for a while. Now you could also change this inside of your Safari settings right here. So you could change it from tab bar to single tab. You also have the option to change the landscape tab bar and the tinting if you want to. So I would just recommend going in here and changing that tab bar to either the top or the bottom, whichever is your preference. Although I will say I would give the bottom bar a chance. If you just installed iOS 15, everybody's first instinct is that they don't like it. Just give it a chance. It took me about a month before I got used to it, but now I never want to go back. Now, the next thing you guys want to do is go into your settings and go to notifications and then go to announce notifications and make sure this is turned on. Make sure that announce notifications and when connected to headphones, and you may also see CarPlay right here, make sure those are enabled. And then you may also want to have reply without confirmation enabled as well. So this in iOS 15, it's no longer announce messages. So now Siri will not only announce your messages when you get them, when you have AirPods in, but it will also announce the notifications that you have set up right here if you want them to. So for me, I have like Chick-fil-A enabled and some of these other applications enabled as well that I would like to hear notifications from, like when I'm on a bike ride or when I just cannot be looking at my iPhone. Now, one of the best features in iOS 15 is live text. And this is a feature where if you hold your camera up to like a sign or up to something with text on it, it can transcribe it in real time and you can copy that to your notes or, you know, send it in a message, whatever you want to do with it. So this feature is really awesome, but some people are not going to like it. And if you don't like it, you could actually turn this off. And you could do that by going into your settings and then going all the way down to the camera and then down to live text. So if you turn live text off, it will turn off the live text in the camera application. Now you're still going to have it for screenshots, like you could still do it in screenshots and photos that you actually take and, you know, save it to your camera roll, but you won't be able to do it live, you know, when you have the camera application pulled up and in real time. The next thing you guys need to change is inside of settings and privacy. If you go all the way down to record app activity, you want to make sure that this is turned on. So this is new in iOS 15, and you can see right here it says, save a 7-day summary of when applications access your data, like your location or microphone, and see when apps or websites you visit within apps contact domains. So you want this to be on and you want to have this data saved. So as of right now, there is no UI right here that shows when apps access your data, but in a future iOS 15 release, you will see that right here. And you want to make sure that this is enabled for when that time comes. And then the final thing you guys should change in iOS 15 is also here under the privacy section. And if you go to location services and then all the way down to system services and then all the way down to significant locations, you want to make sure that is disabled. That's basically just going to be following you around and keeping a log of where you go every single day, which will not only eat up your battery life, but it's also going to eat up your data. So that I would also go ahead and consider disabling most of these system services because you just simply do not need them. So things like cell network search, compass calibration, device management, system customization, we have the product improvement toggles right here, both disabled. You want to disable probably most of these. And basically all this is doing is, again, it's for your system services, for the location. It's not disabling these features. Like if you disable the HomeKit right here, it's not going to disable HomeKit. It's only going to disable the location-based features of HomeKit. So that's why you can disable most of these in here, because most are not going to matter. Like setting time zone, unless you're traveling all the time, you don't need that enabled. You know, you don't need the compass calibration, things like that. Nothing in here you really need enabled besides maybe like Find My iPhone, maybe emergency calls and SOS, things that are actually going to matter at the end of the day. So there you have it, guys. Those are about 20 settings that you should be aware of and that you may want to change on your iOS 15 device. Now, if you guys want to see another episode like this with more settings to change, let me know down in a comment below and also let me know with a thumbs up on this video. So if you want to see that, make sure you subscribe to the channel so you get notified when that goes up. And if you want to see all of my other iOS 15 videos, those are all linked down in the description below, along with the iPhone 13 videos coming very soon. But anyways, guys, thanks again for watching, and I'll see you soon.